Ayo, what is up? I'm going to show you how to install the Camera Shakify add-on to Blender 4.0. It's a really neat way to add some realistic feeling camera shake to otherwise dull and smooth video shots. I use it a ton and it makes my scenes come to life. So let's jump right in. So we've got Blender here. We're going to hit play on this. You'll see the video right now. The camera pans to the front corner of the car and back, and it's very smooth. We want to add a little bit of camera shake to make it feel a little bit more real. We can do that with an add-on called Camera Shakify. So I'll show you how to install that right now. All right, first thing you want to do is open up a browser, and in the search bar, type in Camera Shakify Blender. Search for that. You want to look for the one that says GitHub Eat the Future / Camera Shakify. Go ahead, click that. You'll notice that this one works for Blender 2.91 or later. Since we're using Blender 4.0, this will be the one we want to download. To download this, click on the code, download the zip, and that should appear in your downloads. Here it is, Camera Shakify Master. Then go back to your Blender project, hit edit, and at the bottom, preferences. Make sure you've got the add-on selected. We're going to hit install here. We're going to search our downloads. Double click on your zip folder that you just downloaded. And once that is installed here, you'll see it. I'll just expand this. You'll want to check the box to enable it. There's also this bottom panel here, this little arrow, you can see it. I'm going to click on that. It says preferences. Just make sure that your autosave preferences is enabled, or go ahead and hit save preferences. That way you make sure you save the add-ons that you install and enable. Once you've done that, go ahead and hit close. And you'll see over here already, when I added the Camera Shakify add-on, it populated under the data tab here in this panel. The Camera Shakify box is right here. So you'll see that it added the close-up shake to it. If you want to add or change the camera shake, you just hit the plus button. That'll add some camera shake. This one says investigation. There's a bunch of different types, and you'll just want to experiment with this and get a feel for it. Whatever one you like best, what works for the shot. I'll go ahead and hit play and you can see what that looks like. So here's the investigation shake. You'll see here that it's pretty wobbly. There's a little bit more motion than I would like for this shot, especially since I'm clipping out of the shot. I guess I would like to change this one. So click that drop-down menu, and let's select the close-up. Much more steady, but there is a little bit of shake here. Just barely. It's hard to tell. You can change the scale if you want it to, you know, move a little bit more. I usually leave that at a 1, but sometimes we'll adjust it. There's other ones like Handycam Run, so if the person was running, that's what it could look like. Just makes it feel a little bit more real. And you can adjust these settings. You can add more shake types together, so you can add a few different ones. I usually just use 1, and you'll see the difference here. Again, no shake at all added to this shot. I add in the investigation, and look at that. It's much more, feels like there's a person behind the camera, I guess. And that's about it. Oh, a couple tips are, once you have the Shakify added, it sometimes adds a constraint, so you're not able to move the camera freely, but there are ways to move the camera still using your grab, typing in G. You can still move it this way, and of course, you hit your coordinates, X, Y, or Z, you can move it like that. And that's it. Oh, one other tip I wanted to show was that you can add in multiple shake types here and be able to switch between them. All you have to do is add in keyframes. There's actually videos on YouTube already that explain this very well. I'd recommend you go watch them. But otherwise, if you want me to make a video on that, I'd be happy to. Just leave a comment down below.